Los Angeles! That's right. And I'm gonna tell it all night. Woo! Hey! Feeling good? My intro rap was so good last night in San Francisco that Jim made fun of it the whole drive down. So I've changed my strategy. Changed my strategy, y'all. I'm reborn today in Los Angeles, y'all. That's right, it's a new look at everything. Nice to meet me. Pleased to meet me. Hey, ain't that a bitch? Hey, ain't that a bitch? I'm not even gonna play guitar. You know what Jim said? I'm gonna tell everything. All right, we'll get to that. Cheers, Los Angeles. Y'all go drink with me. Whatever you got, Perrier, baby. Yes. I'm gonna play some Mississippi Fred McDowell. That's what I'm gonna do first, though. And besides, I'm gonna sit my ass down. Thank you. Thank you guys for coming, all of you.
Don't worry, no problem.
Just enjoy the show. I'm gonna tell
you about the day. No, really, I mean it. Don't worry.
Way back, all the way back in the good old days, you know here. Ladies, is that too loud, girls? Y'all all right? It's always a minute. Turn it up. We're trying to be a gentleman. Los Angeles. This is my father's favorite town, y'all know that. My brother's like, well, why don't we just move there? Come on, let's go. He said, well, you know, if they send for you and bring you to Los Angeles, then you're exotic. That's his trip. But he did the right thing, because he raised us outside of Memphis, Tennessee, y'all. Yeah. See, me and my friends, we grew up listening to Dad and his friends. They all had kids. We all grew up listening to them play music, y'all. Ever since I was just wee high from my grandma's hobby, y'all, I said, I'm gonna play the guitar. My dad was like, well, you better practice because you ain't hitting all shit. I'm not gonna bullshit you. He never did bullshit me. See, our dad, his dad, growing up in Memphis, Tennessee in the 1950s, that's rock and roll heaven for a teenage kid, you know? The dad and his friends, they were bohemians, not hippies. No. Dad said the first time he saw a hippie in Memphis, he was like, oh, shit. He said they took their lifestyle and made it offensive, even to them. So the bohemians in the 60s collided with the Memphis blues men who'd been right there in Memphis, Tennessee all along. I'm talking about Furry Lewis, Gus Cannon, Will Shane, Sleepy John Estes, y'all, Bucka White, Fred McDowell coming through there. Robert Wilkins, but he was sanctified by the time. But the bitch of it was, you know, like everybody in that generation, they were finding the blues in the records. You know, I mean, Dad remembered before TV, but so it's before rock and roll and before they found any blues on a radio. We've seen a hell of a lot of changes in our lifetimes. And some things still stay the same. But what it took, the music kids, the students from the North, namely John Fahey, Charlie Brown, Bill Barth. See, these cats had a slightly different perspective listening to their blues records. They jumped in their cars and drove down south and found these bluesmen and pulled them out of obscurity. They had the perspective to come down and pull them out of segregation and revitalize their careers and bring these bluesmen later in their life back to the whole world. It was a beautiful thing, the perspective that these gentlemen had. So here you go. You got the Blues Masters, first generation Blues Masters, colliding with the Bohemians from the North and the South, right there in Memphis, Tennessee, and over to Park Shell. The World Boogie, baby. I'm talking about the Electric Blue Watermelon. Yeah. So we grew up knowing all that. We learned Fruity Lewis, we learned Casey Jones, Fredding Down. We learned how to shake them all down. You see, that was Dad's thing. I found my own thing. I found Black Flag when I was 12 years old. Six-pack single, you know the one. Raymond Pettibone on the cover band. Yeah! So I was playing my little guitar. I was trying to figure out how to play Black Flag. I asked my dad for help. And he got so mad. He's like, what is this shit? This don't make any sense. Damn it! I was like, yes. When I first put that needle on the six-pack single, man, I was like, now this is music from my planet, my people. So, of course, I knew about the blues growing up. And I loved it. The more primitive, the better. Old time. But that was a thing of dirty, that's right. Thing of the past. I didn't like modern blues. We used to make bad fun of it. But then I got to know Arthur Turner and his family when I was a teenager. Got to know Kenny Brown from Nesbitt, Mississippi, playing that slide guitar. He introduced me to Ariel and Cedric and Dwayne and Gary Burnside down there. Hey, Otha, what's going on? I'm gonna get comfortable up in there. Otha carried me down to Junior Kimber's Jr., y'all. Down on Highway 4. Yeah, I couldn't believe it. Here it is, right in my own backyard. Hey, now look, these guys turned me on, but you gotta give the credit where credit's due. Fat Possum Records turned the world on. Yeah! To the Hill Country Blues in the mid-90s, y'all. Junior Kimber's Juke Joint on a Sunday night. Man, it's modern day Mississippi heaven, y'all. It was a beautiful thing in the South. You'd have a beautiful sorority girls from Ole Miss, underage, driving up there dancing with these gnarly old farmers. It's like, get on, baby. You got the big babies, the big mamas from down around the way dancing with the skinny white boys like me. It's just like in the 60s, the blues are pulling people together, you know what I mean? And people are glad to get together. We're glad to get together. See, I'm a musician. I love music. Music is my life. Music is my religion, man. But now I'm growing to think, I think sports people, they can use sports to bring themselves together. Scientists, they bring, use scientists. Science to bring each other together, to study. Because people want to be together. It's everybody else that tries to keep us apart. That said, I'm going to dedicate this show tonight to the concept of peace. The music is a peace offering tonight, yo. A prayer for peace, yo. I know it's never going to happen. But right now, tonight, we can just put out the positive vibes and just think about it as a prayer for peace, y'all. Let's not hurt each other no more. So there it was. Couldn't believe it happened again. Young kids from down south with the blues masters getting it on. The world boogie lives again. It's driving me crazy, man. Mississippi Fred McDowell, R.L. Burnside, Junior Kimbrough down there. So that's the backstory. That's the setup. Here we go. It's one day it changed my life, y'all. Hanging out down at my friend's place outside of Water Valley, Mississippi, which is just south of Keep Running, Mississippi. Water Valley, that's nowhere. He was staying up at the... He was crashing out in the single-wide trailer out back behind Grandmama and them's. And all day long in the summer heat, we've been taking motorcycles and riding mushrooms, y'all. Sun went down, we were riding those motorcycles off in the slippery grass in the fields. My brother jumped on a motorcycle, he hollered out, "Dwayne!" and rode off. And his headlight just fell over and went out. My thing is, I don't think guitar playing and motorcycle riding really go together if you look at the step. So late that night after trying to chill out and let the shrooms wear off, I'm laying on a green shag multicolored carpet of my friend's single wide trailer out there back behind Grandmama and them's, y'all. About 1996, y'all. Early June. 20 years ago. Listen to Fred McDowell play this song right here. I'm crazy about you. I'm crazy about you, baby. Laying there on the floor, I had an epiphany. I couldn't take it any longer. I said, fuck it, I can't take it. I got to play this music, participate in this tradition with my friends and these musicians I love. I'm going to start a band called the North Mississippi All-Stars. I'm going to play the North Mississippi Hill Country Blues. And that night changed my life, man. I came around the world, brought me here to you today. Thank you, Los Angeles. I'm from Mississippi, y'all. No, I'm from Mississippi. Come on, Jim.
I'm crazy about
quit. Oh, quit. Don't you bet? To my friend Otha Turner's house down. My friend R.L. Boyce, we'd sit on that porch and play this riff all night long. Even until Otha got good enough to pass his little bottle of corn and little whiskey around, or until they jumped up and started singing, y'all. Otha Turner was 94 years old. He passed away. He was the last of the great Mississippi cane pipe blowers until his granddaughter Sharday took it up and kept it along with us, y'all. I'm going to sing this one tonight for Otha and Bernice Turner and Sharday Thomas, y'all. Otha jump up, throw his hat down, and start singing like this. If your bed breaks down, baby. If your bed breaks down, baby. Make it right down on your floor. Make it kind of easy. Make it right behind your door. Please, please, baby. Please, baby. Give me a little more time. I won't get hairy. My teeth are brown on mine. Every time, OT. I asked Otho to turn out, I said, so Otho, if you break the girl's bed down and you gonna make it on the floor, why you gonna lay your pallet down behind the dough? Otho was slick, man. Otho was slick. He had a self-sufficient farm. He had every animal you could imagine that he could talk to and control. He grew all his own food. He didn't care for modern life whatsoever. He had a girlfriend on either side of the same gravel street till the day he died, y'all. Otho said, you make the pallet down on the floor, so if home man happens to come in while you're doing your business, and you just slip behind the dough and wait until he passes before you ease out.
Hey! Otho!
Thank y'all. All right, now this whole tour, this is the last night of the tour, y'all. I'm starting about, this starts way back. And we worked our way up to Boston, down to the Gulf Coast. This whole tour, every night I've been playing a little guitar with just a microphone, y'all. We're gonna get it on tonight. Yeah, let's hit it up. We're gonna cut this monitor off, put this microphone right up on this guitar. Here we go. Back in 09, my dad fell sick and passed away, and our first daughter was born. And during that period of time, I wrote a lot of instrumental guitar music inspired by John Fahey and Jack Rose. And this is music from that period of time. Thank you.
good friend gonna join me in a minute, y'all. Oh.
Makes me think back, man. I can't tell it all. I look death dead in the eye as they pass me by. See you in the sun. Here for your father, come for you a little, here for your father. And when that day comes, death comes back my way, I would hope to be as brave as he was on Judgment Day. I would hope to be as brave as he was on Judgment Day. No grave, roll his body down. No grave, hold his body down. Ain't no grave, hold his body down. I see him in the face of my newborn baby child. Baby time spinning in the sky. Baby girl looks me straight in the eye. He'd be here today and sit down at the piano and play. Sit down at the piano and play. I would hope to be as brave as he was on Judgment Day. There ain't no way to hold his body down, no way to hold his body down. He's been my fortune and no tune again now. I heard the music of those fears. I heard the music of those fears. I am unrepentant, I have no fear. I heard the music of those fears. Thank you. much, y'all. Play Devil from Pops right there. Yes, thank you. If a main man from Memphis, Tennessee is in the house, Joe Slubby, he can join me at any time at his leisure, y'all. Woo, what y'all want here? Jay-Z Jones. I ain't playing Pope Black Man. You got the wrong situation. Do we have a moment, Los Angeles? I am not going to tell if you don't tell. Y'all be on the internet telling everything. Co-wrote with my father and a great guitar player from Memphis, Tennessee, Mr. Lee Baker, y'all. Holy Baker. Hey, we've been having so much fun. We've been waiting for so long to play together. This tour has been great. George Slubick from Memphis, Tennessee lives right here in Los Angeles. Let's bump that shit, bump it. We'll be right back. they woke up shoot the whole night. Drink from a bottle and ball in the moonlight. Bang, bang, in the moon. Don't bang on wet. What you gonna do for fighting? With the loose head gone. This woman knows there's no one who wants to take the shit out of. Ball in a chain. When you hear the whistle moan, Vacation, Los Angeles. I'm leaving town in the morning and I already lost the hair mask. Fuck! I don't even have a room. I'm just driving to LAX. I'm gonna lay down in the van for a minute before I drop it off. It's been so much fun. Thank y'all for joining us. It means the world to us. We cannot do it by ourselves when we can, but it's not that much fun. You know how I go. We love doing it. Cutting the grass in Mississippi, inspired by my good friend Sid Silva, y'all.
I live out in the country, biggest yard you ever seen. My old lady, she liked to keep it clean. There ain't no yard, man. There ain't no yard, man, son. She won't pay to get it done. I bought it riding no more. The dirty son of a bitch won't run. Well, I hit that road and my name is up in lights. The big city boy, we all rock all night. Yeah, back home in the country, chopping wood in the morning light. I ain't no young man. We'll be right back. road. Well, good Lord, there's a road. There's a wheel in the sky. And by, let it roll, good Lord, but let it roll, good Lord. If you put that tone, let it roll, good Lord, let it roll.
Thank you.
she has not been acting right lately.
I've been doing well.
Jones is ready and bumping on go.
Sing with your
she shaking like she could be pigeon wing. Could a pigeon wing, though? Could a pigeon wing? Could a pigeon wing? Lord, she would you? She would you? She would you?
Every get out.
the ground. Don't bury me in this greasy ground. Thank you.
I just tune that up for next time. Just getting it ready for next time. It's like making your bed, you know? I don't really make my bed as much as I just roll up my bedroll. You know? Even when I'm at home. You know where that song came from? My friend R.L. Boyce, I was telling you about? Down in Uthers? His wife, Sheila. Sheila crazy. I saw Sheila at the picnic. I was like, Sheila, I'm so glad to see you. So glad he made it. She's like, you can't keep the devil down. Dirty Red in the first verse, that's Gary Burnside's older cousin on Big Mama's side, Dirty Red. Yeah.
train.
Tour, we're gonna wind it down for y'all right now. Thank y'all so much for joining us. Let's put a ride and ride on. George Subbert and Lottie Jim Lauderdale, y'all. All right.
How about these guys, huh? This is a song.
song that's off the record that Luther produced not too long ago. I'll tell you what, you guys are on fire tonight, man. What kind of music are we playing, Jim?
Hellfire!
This is some soul-searching music. Thank you.
some soul searching, watching the lion purring, until some truth's occurring. Contract to me, man.
Just listen to my tape, man. Hey, look, we're going to tell everybody. We were watching Hustle and Flow. You remember the end?
Just listen to my tape, man.
Thank you.
I'm not done since this is our last night. I'm not done.
Don't be done.
Bringing every bit of gusto out of every second I have left with
yes,
you guys.
Sir.
That it was
Okay, we'll try this one. It's a song that I got to write with Robert Hunter.
Nice. Woo! Grateful Dead.
Yeah, you know, folks, we've never done this song before live. But we did stay last night at a Holiday Inn Express. And so... My guitar is a tune and everything.
works out.
We got one more, y'all. Thank y'all so much.
Thank you. Thank you.
G-strings is all tangled up.
I'm gonna lay down by the
riverside, down by the riverside, down by the riverside, down by the riverside,
gonna lay down my burden,
down by the riverside, gonna stay here for no more. I ain't gonna study war no more,
ain't gonna study
war.
Down by the riverside,
down by the riverside,
down by the riverside,
oh Mary,
let it tumble.